Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You're watching ProTech. Last time we reviewed the last Android 16 beta 2. You can check the review of that update from the icard link. Few days before Google released its next beta 3 update for upcoming Android 16 update for their Pixel series devices. As I am not using any Pixel device, but who are adventurous techies who can make impossible things into the possible in this tech world. So we booted the ported build of new Android 16 beta 3 build on my OnePlus 9RT. And today we are going to review some of the new and the interesting changes of this update. All the Android device users who didn't using the Pixel devices can also try this build if you want to test how Android 16 beta 3 feels and the looks on your device. So watch this video till the end. Now without further delay, let's get started. This is the homepage I set it after the booting the new Android 16 beta 3 on my 9RT. There are no major overhaul in this update, but it comes with the new small features and the changes. Let's check out the major changes done by the Google for this update. The first major change is done by the Google is for the new Easter egg. If you access the Easter egg of Android 16 beta 3, now the spaceship icon is visible in the status bar. If we check the notification panel, it will show us the Easter egg is running in the manual mode. Most of users didn't know how to play the hidden Easter egg game of Android 16. It's similar to the Android 15 build, but now the Google added the new auto mode. If you tap on it, spaceship will automatically traverse to nearby planets of universe which has the solid surface. Status bar notification of Easter egg will now show us the auto mode of Easter egg. It will also show us the direction and the distance covered by the spaceship. Once Easter egg lands on any planet, it will be notified in the notification panel with the planet name. Like here, it's showing the spaceship landed on the Cancer Epsilon 2. Later, we can drive the spaceship again and can land on other planets in auto mode. So, auto mode is just an overview of this Easter egg for users who didn't know about this Easter egg game. Next one is a small change. Google added the new close button for recent panel applications. This is just not an app close button which acts like the swipe up dispense action that we were previously using to close the applications. But it will actually force stop the application and its background activities. In previous Android version, to force close the application we need to follow the force close activity via system application and by tapping the force stop button available in the setting. Next is not a new change, but it's actually not working in the previous GSI Android 16 beta 2 build. User switch widgets was not working in the old build, but it's now working perfectly in this new Android 16 beta 3. Next, search bar in the settings of the new Android 16 beta 3 has a black outline which was not present in the old beta 2 build. Last and the big change of this update is the new battery health option is now available in the battery option of the setting. At the top of this setting, it will show us the current battery status of your device. If it's showing the normal, then nothing to worry about the battery. Next, we got the current battery capacity, which determines the estimated percentage of charged battery can hold compared to the new standard battery. If it shows below the 80% or below, you need to change your device battery. Next, we get the battery health article option, which will show you the different methods to save your device battery. So these are the few changes of this update. Others are the Pixel device specific fixes done by the Google, which are not related to this GSI build. Everything is working for me in this build for my OnePlus 9RT, including the mobile network and the calling. Only safety net is failing. The bugs may vary for different devices as per their device model. By using the DS loader, you can test such build of the custom GSI on any device. You can check our iCard video so you can easily flash the GSI, can test the newer Android versions or any OEM ROMs and the custom GSI as a dual boot along with your primary ROM. This is all about for today guys. Hope you liked our work. Then please do like and share this video. Subscribe to our channel. Press the bell icon for the notifications of our upcoming content. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye bye.